What's up, everyone? It's Crystal here on the Crystal Cares Yoga channel. We're doing a yin class in the next 45 minutes. So for yin practice, which is a restorative practice, we'll be holding postures anywhere from 1 to 5 minutes of pose. You may want some props to assist your practice. Perhaps some blocks. If you don't have blocks at home, you can use books or stacks of magazines, a blanket, you will likely have that at home, and a bolster. If you don't have a bolster, feel free to grab a pillow or something soft. All right, so we will get started on our backs in Supta Baddha Konasana. So, bring your sits bones to the mat, step the feet just below the sits bones, recline the spine back one vertebrae at a time. Melt the shoulders down into the mat. Give your chin a gentle tuck down towards your collarbone so that the crown of your head can lengthen up. Relax your hands down by your sides. Then bring the soles of your feet together as you let the knees fall off to the sides. Option here to place your two blocks on the outsides of the knees, just to give it a little bit of support. But if you like the deeper opening sensation, you do not need to use those blocks. Take a big breath in. Exhale, let the body melt. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Just find your breath here. Stable, consistent. And as you do, let the thoughts, the worries, the anxiety all just clear away from your mind. Maybe you were wrapped up in the news for too long today. You're here now. So be here. From Patanjali's Yoga Sutras. There are 10 concepts called the Yamas and the Niyamas. I like to think of those as sort of the 10 commandments of yoga. They serve as a moral framework for us yogis to live by. And the first Yama is called Ahimsa. I think that's my favorite yama. Ahimsa means non-violence or non-harming. But it goes beyond just the sheer avoidance of violence. Ahimsa calls us to change our mindset, to replace all hatred in our minds with love, every bit. It calls us to live into compassion, to live into forgiveness. For love, for compassion, for forgiveness. I think we become the most powerful versions of ourselves. Love is power in its purest form. And don't lose the breath here. Let the body get heavier with each exhale. Let it root down into the earth. Become one with it. One more deep breath here. Inhale. Exhale. Remove the blocks if you had them tucked under your thighs. Then place the hands on the outsides of the thighs. Gently draw the knees back in towards the midline. Let the knees fall over to the right side. Inhale, bring them back to center. Exhale, they fall to the left. Windshield wiper side to side. Exhale to the right. Center, inhale. Left exhale. Take it on your own for a couple of rounds. Just gently warm up the spine and the low back, the hips. And stay over onto one side. Curl over into your fetal position. Press your palms down into the mat. And bring yourself up into a tabletop. So bring the shoulders right over the wrists and the hips right over the knees. Inhale, tip the head and tailbone up for cow spine. Exhale, round out the back cat spine. Inhale, cow. Exhale, cow. One more inhale, round it out, exhale. Back to neutral spine, so lengthen from the crown through the tailbone. Gently hug the ribs in towards the midline, and then flip the wrists around so that the fingertips are turned towards the knees. So it's a pretty intense stretch for some of us on the outsides of our wrists, especially if you're someone who works from a computer often or typing. Our forearms can get very tight. And take a few cat-cows here. Inhale. Exhale. And if you're finding that this is too intense on your wrists here, you can take the edge of your blanket folded up like so underneath the wrist. So not quite as much intensity. Exhale, round out the back. Inhale, lift it up. Exhale, round the back. One more inhale. Round back. Then keep the fingertips pointed towards the knees, but flip the wrists over the other way so that the palms are facing up. Again, this can be a little intense for some of us, so option to rest the hands on your blanket here. Inhale, cow spine. Exhale, cat. Inhale, cat. Exhale, cat. One more time, inhale, cow. Exhale, cow. Unflip the wrists. Extend your left foot straight back behind you. Press into the left heel to stretch through that back calf muscle. Inhale. Exhale. Bring the left knee down to the mat. Extend the right knee back behind you. Press through the left heel, stretch through the calf. Inhale. Exhale. Lower the right knee back to the mat. And then bring your big toes together. Walk your knees slightly out to the edges of your mat. Send your hips back towards your heels for child's pose. We're going to take a little variation here using your blocks or books or whatever you've found to replace those. So bring the heart forward as you would in child's pose. Reach the arms over your blocks. You want them to line up just under the knee, just under the elbow joint, and to support the tricep. Bring your hands together here, and then fold the palms back behind the head. Let your head rest down in between the blocks, and keep letting the heart melt down towards the mat. So this variation of child's pose allows us to find a little extra opening through our shoulders and through the triceps. My sweatshirt has magically disappeared. Take one more full deep breath here. Inhale. Exhale. Release the bind of your hands. Re-extend the elbows. Lift the heart up off the mat. Walk the hands back. Put the blocks to the side for a moment, then come back to your tabletop position. Again, hips over knees, shoulders over wrists. We'll walk our hands forward into puppy pose. So keep your hips where they're at over your knees and just walk the hands forward. And then melt the heart down towards the mat. Option to kickstand up on your chin here for an extra throat opening. So options for props here. I sometimes like to place a block right under my chin. Makes it a little bit more accessible to find that throat opening sensation here. Another alternative is taking your bolster and sliding that one underneath your chest. And then your chin just hangs over the edge. Breathe deeply. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more breath. Inhale. Walk the hands back. Lift the heart up off the mat. Send the hips back towards the heels. And then we're going to work on stretching the tops of our feet here. So if you know you already have very tight ankles around the tops of your feet. Option to take a rolled blanket and tuck it underneath the ankles. Good. And then bring the tops of the toes down towards the mat. And then lean into the right side. Walk the hands back. And then lift the right knee up off your blanket if it's there, or just off of the mat. And then breathe into the top of the right foot just for a couple of breaths. Inhale. Ease the mind. Exhale. Come back to Ahimsa. Nonviolence. It's okay to take your body to its edge, but notice if you're doing so to better yourself, to better your practice, or if you are being violent with yourself. One more breath here. Inhale. Exhale. Lower the knee, walk the hands back. And then we switch it over to the left side. So lean the weight into the left heel. Walk the hands back again. Left knee lifts off the blanket or the mat. Breathe into the top of the foot. One more breath here. Inhale. Exhale, lower it down towards the mat. Walk the hands back, shift the weight forward. Slide that blanket out from under you. The bolster too if it's there. Walk the hands forward, then lower the heart down towards the mat. You might need to clear some space. I've made a mess here with all of my props. And then extend the right arm straight out to the side. So coming straight out from the shoulder, bend the left foot, and then step the sole of the left foot outside of the right leg. So you can see, you can't see my right arm on this side because it is reaching back behind me. Connect the sole of your foot to the mat, knee points up towards the ceiling. Breathe through the right shoulder, inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. This is called broken wing pose. If you need a little extra intensity here, you can take a goal post in the right arm, bending it at a 90 degree angle. If you need a little bit less, you can fold the weight forward. So you're not leaning all of your weight onto the right shoulder, maybe just on your side body. So find your variation and deepen the breath. Notice the internal dialogue that you have with yourself here. Most of us are much more conscious about being nonviolent with others than we are with ourselves. But violence is not always actions, it's words and thoughts as well.
What thoughts are you giving yourself right now? Let it be a peaceful one. One of love, one of compassion, one of forgiveness. One more breath here. Inhale. Exhale. Slowly roll back to the belly. Draw the right palm back under the right shoulder. Then extend the left palm out to the side. Got props in my way again. So left palm reaches to the side. Bend the right foot, knee rather. Then step the right foot outside of the left leg. Yes. So we get options here. If this feels like way too much for you, just curl a little bit over to your side body. Use that opposite arm to support your body at whatever angle the stretch feels appropriate for your shoulder. If you need extra, take the goalpost bend in the left elbow. Find your variation. Get deeper in the breath. One more breath here. Inhale. Exhale. Roll back to the belly nice and slow. And then hug the left palm in underneath the left shoulder. Lift the heart up off the mat. And then inch the elbows forward so that they are right underneath the shoulders for Sphinx pose. Press the palms into the mat, spread the fingertips wide, then draw the elbows back towards the ribs, shoulders pull down the back, and then the heart pulls through the center. So release the lower back here, release the sacrum. Pretty intense heart opener. And keep watching the shoulders here. Don't let them creep up towards the ears. Keep pressing them down. This is a little bit more active than some of our usual yin poses. Nice elongation in the spine. Not breaking any of our vertebrae. Clear channel for the breath to flow. One more breath here. Inhale. Down by the sides. Little baby belly Savasana. Bend the knees. Let them kick side to side. Good. Then come back to the center. We're going to roll onto our backs. So reach your left arm forward. Spiral the right arm underneath it. And then roll onto the shoulders. Inch your booty back to the center of the mat and extend the legs long down below you. Reach the arms up overhead. Interlace the fingertips. Pointer fingers point up. And then we'll walk it over to our right side for banana pose. So feet walk over to the right first. Maybe cross the left ankle over the right ankle. And then inch the shoulders over. Point your fingers, reach down towards the feet. So it's a big side body opener here. Inhale. Find space all through those left ribs. Exhale. Be at peace here. One more full deep breath here. Inhale. Exhale. Walk the feet back to the center. Then inch the shoulders back. Feet walk over to the left side now. Step them off the side of your mat. Maybe cross the right ankle over the left. Then inch the shoulders over, reaching the pointer fingers towards the feet. And breathe space into the left ribs. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Feel the peace within. Let it radiate. One more breath. Inhale. Exhale. Slowly walk the feet back into the center. And then inch the shoulders back to the center. Release the arms down by the sides. Bend the knees. Curl over onto your right side. Coming back onto your belly. So lift up the right arm, thread the left arm under, then set the feet back to come to the belly. Hands under shoulders, shift hips back to tabletop. Extend the right leg straight back behind you. Sorry, that's your left leg. Then knee to nose, exhale. Step the left foot forward into low lunge. Sorry, that looked a little awkward.
release the weight of your hips down and forward into the mat. Then walk the left foot across towards your right wrist. Then start to shift the weight over the left knee. Coming into pigeon pose on your left side. So the most important thing here is to keep our hips squared. So if you need to, place a block, blanket, bolster, whatever option feels best for you underneath the left hip here. And then make sure your right hip is facing down, not up like this. Right hip down. And keep the right leg lengthened. So there's no bending of the leg. Untuck the back toe. Lift up through the heart. And then walk it forward to melt your heart down towards the mat. So option to reach the arms fully forward in front of you, or if it feels preferable, you can bend the elbows to make a pillow for yourself on your forearms, or you can use your actual bolster or pillow underneath the head here. Another option I like to do is to rest my arms down by my side. Oh yeah. I could stay here for a while. Find your breath. Where are you choosing ahimsa in your life? Would you choose love and compassion and forgiveness over hatred? One more deep breath here. Inhale. Exhale. Bring your hands under your shoulders. Lift up through the heart. Lift up out of the left hip. And then slide the left foot back into your tabletop. Take a few little shifts side to side, maybe some circles in the hips to neutralize. And then extend the right foot back behind you now. Right knee to nose. Step it through, low lunge. Shift the hips down and forward into the back. Then walk the right foot across towards the left wrist. Then shift the right knee down towards the mat, pigeon on our second side. So remember, we're keeping the hips super squared here. Replace your block, blanket, or bolster on your right side to elevate the right hip. Left hip stays dropped down towards the mat. Lift the heart up high. Inhale.
And then fold the heart over, exhale,
taking whatever variation you need. With the arms extended in front of you, maybe folded under your forehead, or reaching back down by the hips. I'm turning my head to the other side as well, just to make sure my neck and spine are even. How deep can you breathe here? How deep can you love? One more breath. Inhale. Exhale. Bring the hands underneath the shoulders. Lift up the heart. And lift the weight out of the right leg. Slide it back to your tabletop. Shift over either hip. Bring your sits bones down to the mat. Feet stay up by the hips, and then recline the spine back to your mat. Supported bridge pose. Inhale, lift the sacrum up off the mat. Where did my blocks go? Then grab your block and slide it underneath the sacrum here. Let the sacrum melt back into your block. If you want some extra height, you can also take your bolster, line it up over the block that's there, lift the sacrum off. Slide the bolster into place under the sacrum, then set the sacrum back down on the bolster. You have three choices here. The first is to stay right where you are in this beautiful supported bridge. The second choice is to step the feet up towards the ceiling for supported shoulder stand. The third choice, take a bend in the knees, drop them closer to the chest, then touch the toes back behind your head for plow pose. So listen to your body as you make these choices. Find what feels the most ahimsa in your physical body.
you are in plow pose, take one more deep breath here. Inhale. Exhale. Slowly lower the sacrum back towards the mat. Bring the feet back up overhead into supported shoulder stand. From supported shoulder stand, step the feet back down to the mat for your supported bridge pose. From supported bridge pose, lift the sacrum off your block or bolster, slide it out from under you. Your second block as well, if it's there. Then one vertebrae at a time, release the upper back, the mid back, the low back, then the sacrum. Back to the mat. Take both knees over to the right side for supine twist. Let the knees stack one on top of the other here. Option to place your blanket in between your knees to cushion those joints. Maybe a little extra. So you can always adjust your props however they feel best for your body. And then once you've done that, inch the right shoulder over to the right side edge of your mat so that there's extra space to flatten the left shoulder back down to the mat. So again, knees are stacked one on top of the other, ankles and feet are stacked, and both shoulders are flat against your mat here. See lengthening through the spine, up through the crown of the head as you inhale. And as you exhale, soften the left shoulder. Maybe even take the gaze over the left shoulder. Your breath is everything. Let it fill you up and release. One more big breath here. Inhale and exhale. Bring the knees center. Inhale. Let them fall to the left side. Exhale. Knees are stacked. Ankles and feet are stacked. Inch the left shoulder over to the left side edge of the mat. Make space for the right shoulder to flatten. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale. Release the shoulders. Maybe gaze over the right shoulder. Yeah.
is Gandhi, who said that there is no industry or activity that is possible without a certain amount of violence, no matter how little. Even the very process of living is impossible without that certain amount of violence. But what we have to do, what our obligation as humans to do, is to minimize that violence as much as possible. So what more can we do to minimize violence in the world? Right now, it feels like the best way to minimize violence in the world is by staying home on a couch or on our yoga mats. And as challenging as it may be, there is comfort in knowing that we are living into the principle of Ahimsa, that we are serving a greater purpose of love and compassion for the world, compassion for our most vulnerable, for our elderly. One more full deep breath here. Inhale. Exhale. Bring the knees back to center. Inhale. Recenter the hips and remove the block or blanket, whatever you got. And exhale. Step the feet down below you, coming into your final Savasana. Wrap yourself up with any extra clothing or props or blankets that you would like to use here. Make it so that you are at your ultimate state of comfort, free of distraction, free to be without worry, free to simply just be. Rest as long as your body needs. Bring your hands up to your heart center. It is with tremendous love and gratitude that I offer this practice to you. Letting that gratitude fill up my heart. For those of you who are watching this video, thank you. Keep breathing and keep practicing. Namaste.